Hello everyone and welcome to Unacademy platform. So myself Dr. Muskan Chaudhary and I will be your mentor for NEET PG Microbiology. Before starting today's topic, we will studying other flagellates, Leishmania, and we'll be studying trypanosome as well. So before starting today's topic, let me acknowledge you with Unacademy platform. As we know that the Unacademy is the India's largest learning platform with the topmost educators and with quality content and the great learning experience. With that, the students get the daily live class in which the student and the educator can interact with themselves, can ask their doubts and queries, and can make their topics more stronger and can do the answer polling that too within the live class. Right, and for that the structured courses are being prepared day and night by the topmost educators on the Unacademy platform. So structured course and the study is something that is needed to crack any competitive exam, and repetitive revision is the key for the any competitive exam, because notes are same for all the students, but how many revisions we do actually matters for the exams, right? So hard study along the smart and the structured study is something that is needed and being provided by the Unacademy platform. And along with that, the student can keep the sessions recorded so that they can watch according to their comfortability, especially for those doctors who are working at the peripheries and do not have actually a good quality of the time for the study, can keep the sessions recorded and can watch according to their shifts and the job that they are doing. And along with that, tests and the quizzes are provided with the by the Unacademy, so that the student can evaluate their performance, can analyze their performance before the real exam, and can do conquer over his anxiety and the fears, right? So moving next, I will recommend you to have at least 1 to 2 year subscriptions. 1 year subscriptions mainly for those students who are the interns and the post interns and who are droppers and want to improve their rank successive in the coming successive year, and 2 year subscriptions mainly for those doctors who are working under financial pressure or who are married and having kids, so they shall have the backup plan for the next year as well, because they even do know that they have not prepared well. So in that case they can take the 2 subscriptions, and it is very economical and cheap compared to other online and offline education platform. So, and please do use my code, that is Muskan, to get 10% of discount on the NEET PG subscriptions. Okay, so moving to the first topic of today, that is the Leishmania. Now the infective form is the promastigate form, and the mode of transmission is by the female sand fly, by the bite of the sand fly. Now female and male, we do get confused. So as we know, it's a very humorous that the females usually suck the blood, so that we can remember that the female sand fly transfers the disease and is a vector for the disease, and by the bite of the female sandfly during the late evening or the night time, right? And the infective form is the promasticate form, and the in humans the form that is present is amastigot form. Now we do get confused ki promasticate form kisme, amastigot form kisme. So how can we remember ki aadmi mein, aadmi from A to A, that aadmi mein amastigot form, and in the fly it is the promastigate form that is present, and by the bite of the female sandfly during the late evening or the night time. Now leishmaniasis is a disease, and habitat is reticuloendothelial cells, mainly the macrophage, that is the immune cells of the person. They inhabitate the infective form in the human, that is the amastigate form in the human, while the infective form is the promastigate form. The what does it do? The female sandfly, the bites on the surface of the skin of the person, and the promastigate forms are released into the bloodstream, and the promastigate form is taken by the reticuloendothelial cells or by the macrophage. And what happens, ke macrophage, they do survive and they are not killed by the macrophage. So what happens in the macrophage, the promastigate form converts into the amastigate form, and what happens, the replication of the amastigate forms takes place in the macrophage, and further they completely full the macrophage with the amastigate, and finally the lysis takes place, and this is how the formation of the LD body takes place. So kya hota hai ki aadmi mein amastigate form hai aur fly mein remaining, that is the promastigate form, aur fly se hi transfer hota infective form, to promastigate form ho gaya, that is present in the sandfly, and which that female sandfly. Okay, now another important point is that ki promastigate forms enters in the skin, macrophage, reticuloendothelial system, immune cells usko lenge and they will convert into the promastigate form, the amastigate form. Theek hai, and amastigate form, what happens, binary fission will takes place and they will completely fill the reticuloendothelial cells, the immunity cells, and finally will cause the lysis. So this is how the LD body is formed, that is the macrophage is filled with the amastigate form, right? And this is very important. And diagnostic form is the amastigate form, as I already told, is found inside the macrophage, and it is what also known as the Leishmania Donovani body. Now moving next, now life cycle is quite easy, that human stage, as I already told you, human stage mein bite, that sandfly will take a bite, will suck the blood from the human skin, and will release the promastigate form, right? And promastigate form will be taken up by the immune cells, reticuloendothelial cells, macrophage. Aur maine kya bataya ki jaise immunity cells जैसे प्रोमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म को ले लेंगे, दिस विल कन्वर्ट इन टू द एमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म. सो क्वेश्चन आर आस्क्ड कि विच फॉर्म इज प्रेजेंट इन द ह्यूमन, दैट इज द एमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म. आदमी में ए से ए एमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म, राइट? सो एमेस्टिगेट ट्रांसफोर्ड, प्रोमेस्टिगेट ट्रांसफोर्ड्स इन टू एमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म, एंड एमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म विल मल्टीप्लाई विद इन द सेल इंक्लूडिंग द मैक्रोफेज ऑफ द वेरियस टिश्यूज लाइक स्प्लीन, बोन मैरो, एंड दिस इज हाउ द एमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म कंप्लीटली अगेन एंड अगेन मल्टीप्लाइज इन टू द immunity cells of the person, and this is how the LD body is formed. Now this is the LD body, we'll see further in the next slide. Now what happens, again the sandfly will take a bite, will suck the blood from the surface of the skin, and ye jo amastigate form hai that is present in the bloodstream, they are taken by the through the blood meal by the sandfly, and the ingestion of the, now the amastigate form again will transfer in the promastigate, and this is how the cycle is completed. But the most important thing for you to remember is ki aadmi mein aise amastigate form hota hai, fly mein bachao promastigate form hota hai. A fly they will actually bite the person, so infective form is the promastigate form, and the diagnostic form is what, amastigate form. Now leishmania ke types hain, that is mainly cutaneous, visceral, and the mucocutaneous, right? And the cutaneous actually resolves spontaneously, so it is not fatal, while the visceral and the mucocutaneous is the more aggressive, and the visceral can be fatal as well, right? So these are the three important clinical manifestations, ya to cutaneous, ya visceral, ya mucocutaneous, right? And the on the cutaneous, skin sores are mainly present, and they may actually even appear after years of the latent infection as well. So now moving next, we're reading one by one. Now this is what, this is the amastigate form that is present in the sandfly, and this is the this is present in the aadmi, that is A2A, that is humans, and this is the promastigate form, that is in the sand fly. Also, one more thing that they have special DNA, that is the kinetoplast. Now, what is kinetoplast? Kinetoplast is the network of DNA in the mitochondria. Not important for you to remember ki hota kya, but for your general knowledge ki kinetoplast kya hota, it is actually a network of the DNA that is present inside the mitochondria. So this is what is a kinetoplast. Now moving next, this is the LD body. As I already told you, that is in the macrophage, the amastigate form will completely again and again multiply, and they even causes the lysis of the macrophage. Now this is again the LD body. As you can see that this is the macrophage and the presence of the amastigate form that is lying in the macrophage cells. Now LD body is important to remember, and it asked the LD body in which form of this Leishman is present is the amastigate form, right? So moving next, and very important that it is the diagnostic value. Therefore, amastigate form or LD body are important for the diagnosis, while the infective form is the promastigate form and is present in the sand fly. Now coming to the important topic. So what were the actually important topics? One more thing, ki reservoir, the vector is the sand fly and the reservoir are mainly mammals, human, dogs, rodents. Now these are the important reservoir for the this leishmaniasis. Now coming to the first leishmania, that is the visceral leishmaniasis or the Kala Azar, and the incubation period is about 3 to 6 months. Now it is caused this Kala Azar and visceral leishmaniasis is mainly caused by the Leishmania donovani, Leishmania infantum, and Leishmania chagas. Now in the Kala Azar, as I told you, it is aggressive disease, and so bone marrow involvement is important, that bone marrow involvement takes place. Now one more thing, the vector is the same, that the sandfly phlebotomus is the vector, along with this the reservoir we have talked, but in India no extra human reservoir is present, right? So in India no extra human reservoir is present. Okay, now as bone marrow involvement was, so anemia, leukopenia, thrombocytopenia, subpenia, all will be decreased, so leading to the pancytopenia, and this is an important clinical manifestation of the Kala Azar, right? So pancytopenia, and very important that hypergamma immunoglobulinemia will takes place. While it is not specific for the hypergamma globulinemia, because immunoglobulins can be raised in other infections like autoimmune ho gaya, multiple myeloma ho gaya, other autoimmune disorders, so it is non-specific, but it is an important feature that in Kala Azar what happens ki bone marrow ke involvement hoga, bone marrow ke involvement to anemia, leukopenia, sub decrease RBC, WBC and the platelets, so leading to the pancytopenia, right? And along with this the hypergamma globinemia, that is the increased reaction of the immunity leading to increased immunoglobulins, so hypergamma globinemia will takes place, right? And the enlargement of the spleen and the liver, this is important to remember that enlargement of the spleen and liver is also present, right? And the fever and hyperpigmentation and the lymph node enlargement, Kala Azar with HIV will present with the absence of the hepatosplenomegaly. Other GIT and the respiratory symptoms are important. What was important to remember, one is that the bone marrow involvement will takes place leading to the pancytopenia and the hypergamma globinemia, right? And enlargement of the spleen causing this splenomegaly and hepatomegaly is along with that is also present, right? Now mainly it is reported from the South Europe, France, Italy and Spain, and India it is reported. In India it is important to remember that mainly it reported from the Bihar, and the sub-Himalayan regions, right? And diagnosis, a diagnosis we already seen ki aadmi mein A-mastigate form hai, so diagnostic value is for the A-mastigate form. And the Buffy-Cott region. Now, when the blood culture is done, Buffy-Cott region of the blood, antibodies are mainly negative. Now, most common important point is the most common cause of the death is secondary bacterial infection. Now, moving next, this is the same Kala Azar or the visceral leishmaniasis. The dum-dum fever. Now, Kalazar was also called as the dum-dum fever after from the Calcutta, and the symptoms are that same one is the hepatosplenomegaly, swollen lymph nodes, very important, that is the pancytopenia, hypergammaglobulinemia. The symptoms will be same, and the parasites are mainly found, we have seen that they are mainly found in the liver, spleen and the bone marrow, and if left untreated it is fatal, and it is the most aggressive form of the leishmaniasis. Now coming to the another, that is the post Kala Azar dermal leishmaniasis. Now it is seen after 2 to 10 years after the treatment, right? So after the 2 to 10 years after the treatment of the visceral leishmaniasis, post Kala Azar dermal leishmaniasis takes place, and its incidence is among patients with visceral leishmaniasis mainly in from the Sudan, and India it is common, it is not that common. And what is the clinical presentation is that non-ulcerative hypopigmented ulcer lesions which later becomes the nodular, right, and may persist even for the 20 years, and the long courses of the antimonials is given. So what is the important point, that the post Kala Azar dermal leishmaniasis actually occurs after 2 to 10 years after the treatment of the visceral leishmaniasis, and the patient will present with the non-ulcerative hypopigmented lesions. Now, what is the important virulence factor for the leishmania? Now, glycoprotein, lipophosphoglycan, and the glycosylphosphatidyl inositol. So, these are the important virulence factor, and depending on the host immune response, T helper TH1 response will be protective response and will give leishmania test positive, right? If leishmania test is positive, we'll read further. Agar leishmania test is positive, that means the response of the person is protective and will be positive in case of the treated patients. And T helper 2 response indicates the disease progression, and leishmania test is negative. Leishmania test is negative means indicate that the infection is active. Now moving to the important laboratory diagnosis. Now for the sample we take more sensitive is the spleen aspiration, then bone marrow aspiration, then liver, lymph node, and last is the Buffy-Cott, because Buffy-Cott is the least sensitive, right? The most sensitive is the spleen aspiration. The spleen aspiration is the most sensitive, followed by the bone marrow, lymph node, liver, and the lymph node, and the least sensitive is the Buffy-Cott, right? And after taking the sample, we do the microscopy. And the stained blood smear examination will demonstrate the Leishmania donovani bodies, that is the A-mastigate form. And we have talked ki aadmi mein A-mastigate form hai, or A-mastigate form is the diagnostic form, so it is important to see the A-mastigate form under the microscopy from the samples that we have collected. Apart from this, the culture, the important culture media that we use is important to remember. One is the NN media, that is MacNeil Norway and Nicole Media, Schindler's Liquid Media. And in this media, the A-mastigate form will transport into the pro-mastigate form. The name of the media is important to remember, especially the NN media and the Schneider's liquid media. Now, serological test is not non-specific. As I among the non-specific serological test is the hyperglobinemia. As I told you, in other conditions also, hypergammaglobinemia takes place. जैसे कि infection हो गया या कोई autoimmune disorder या फिर multiple myeloma or any other malignancy. So it is non-specific test, and is another important to remember the name of the test, that is the Napier's aldehyde and the Chopra's antimony test, right? And the specific we use the CFT, ICT and DAC agglutination test, and the antibodies to specific antigen, that is the RK39 antigen. Right, so laboratory diagnosis, the spleen aspiration is the most sensitive, followed by the bone marrow, and the least sensitive is the buffy coat, the blood specimen. And for the microscopy, we see the diagnostic form, that is the LD body. We have LD body dekhenge, which is the A-mastigate form, and culture, the name of the media is important. We do the culture on the MacNeil, Nicoy, Novi and Nicole media and the Schneider's liquid media. And the hypergammaglobinemia is non-specific test because hyperglobinemia can occurs in other conditions as well, and is detected by the Napier's aldehyde and Chopra's antimony test. Now another, there is the immunochromatographic test, or the direct agglutination test is done, and this ICT is mainly done to see the antibody against a specific antigen, that is the RK39 antigen, right? So moving next, that is the skin test. That is a delayed hypersensitivity test. And another name for the Leishmanian skin test is Montenegro skin test. Right? And as I told you, either the skin test is positive or the skin test is negative. Okay? And in case the skin test is positive, the delayed hypersensitivity test is positive with good cell mediated immunity, and in case of the successful treatment of the patient, and will indicate the lifelong immunity. However, the test is negative in case of the patients with active infection, where the low cell mediated immunity is low. Right, and another we do is very important test, that is the PCR to see the kinetoplast. And what was the kinetoplast? Is the collection of the DNA in the network of the DNA in the mitochondria. So this is a skin test, the intradermal Leishmanian skin test, that is also known as a Montenegro test, and it is either positive in case of the self-resolving asymptomatic high cell mediated immunity, and patients who are successfully treated, in that case the skin test is positive, and the negative in case of the active infections with low cell mediated immunity and diffuse cutaneous leishmaniasis. In case of the positive skin test, after the intradermal injection of the Leishmania antigen, we see the induration within 48 to 72 hours. Now, as you can see, after 48 to 70 hours, we check out the induration at the site of the intramuscular injection, and it is also known as the Montenegro test. Now, coming to the treatment, now the drug of choice is pentavalent antimonials. In most of cases, exception is the Bihar, and we include the sodium stibogluconate and meglumine antimoniate. Important to remember the drug of the choice that we use, but exception is that for the Bihar we give the amphotericin B as the drug of the choice, right? So for the prevention, insect control and sleeping at the top floors can also prevent the transmission. So this was some important basic points. Another than this, we'll talk about the cutaneous leishmaniasis. Cutaneous leishmaniasis is also known as the oriental sore or Delhi boil or Lucknow boil or Baghdad boil. The names are quite easy to remember. The cutaneous leishmaniasis is known as the oriental sore, Delhi, Lucknow and Baghdad boil. And you can see the typical pizza base like ulcer on the skin. The cutaneous leishmaniasis is occasionally resolves spontaneously. And presentation is what? Pizza base like ulcer. At the site of the bite. So at the site of the bite, pizza base like ulcer will appear and can resolve spontaneously in 2 to 10 minutes. So the important one feature is that it is also known as the Baghdad boil, Delhi boil or the Lucknow boil, and it resolves spontaneously, and presentation is the appearance of the pizza base like ulcer. You can completely compare these two, actual pizza base and the pizza base like ulcer, and it is caused by the Leishmania tropica, Leishmania major, Leishmania mexicana and Leishmania ethiopia, right? So this was about some few important points about the this cutaneous leishmania, and treatment is same, that is antimonial compounds are given, as we have seen in already the previous treatment, that sodium stipogluconate and the meglumine antimoniate is given as the treatment, and same for the cutaneous leishmaniasis, and it is not a fatal condition. It generally resolves spontaneously in 2 to 10 months, and pizza base like ulcer is important feature, and cutaneous leishmaniasis ko oriental sore, Delhi boil, Lucknow boil, or Baghdad boil, it is also known as, and at the site of the bite, the pizza base like ulcer will appear, and it is mainly caused by Leishmania tropica major and the Ethiopia. Now sometimes the Leishmania mexicana and Leishmania Ethiopia also causes the diffuse cutaneous leishmaniasis. Now another, we talked about the mucocutaneous leishmaniasis, and it is more aggressive compared to that of the cutaneous leishmaniasis, and occasionally, and this mainly actually involves the nose and the oral cavity, mucocutaneous leishmaniasis. Causing nodular ulceration of the nose, and in case they even heal, so permanent scar will present. Now the 90% of the mucocutaneous are from the Brazil and Peru. Not important to remember from where they are, and is mainly caused by the Leishmania brasiliensis. Now vector is the same, that the vector is the sand fly, and the mucocutaneous leishmania is often not asked in the exam. So important points, just me revise once. Okay. Leishmania, as I told you, how to remember the important features, ki Leishmania infective form is the promastigate form, and the amastigate form is present in the humans, right? So aadmi mein A2A is present in the amastigate form, and the promastigate form is present in the this sand fly. Now by the bite of specifically female sand fly, and females usually they suck more blood of the what to say for the males. So Hari sir, how can we remember that the female sandfly, after sucking of the blood by the bite of the female sandfly, the mode of transmission is, this is how happens, right? So what happens ki female sandfly se kya nikla, promastigate form, and the promastigate form is taken up by the immunity cells of the person, that is a macrophage, and the macrophage mein promastigate form convert kisme hua, amastigate form mein, and this amastigate form will come again multiply within the macrophage, leading to the formation of the LD bodies. And LD bodies is the diagnostic form for the diagnosis of the leishmaniasis. The cycle is the same that I have been told you. Now three basic presentation. One is the cutaneous, on which the skin sores and the pizza like ulcer we have just seen appears. The visceral, that is the 90% of the fatal condition, and the mucosal, involving the mucosal and the oral cavity of the person, mainly the nose and the oral cavity. So, and it is comparatively less common. And coming next, leishmania has the kinetoplast. Now what is kinetoplast? Kinetoplast is also present in the trypanosoma as well as the leishmania. Kinetoplast is a collection of the DNA within the mitochondria, and it is important to remember the presence of the kinetoplast in the leishmania and the trypanosome. Now this is the same leishmania body, that is, this is the macrophage containing the amastigate form, that is completely divides within the macrophage, and this is how, this is the diagnostic form, and this is how the LD body appears under the microscopy. As I told you, vector kya hai, sandfly hai, flea bottomers hai, and the vectors are mainly mammals. But in India, in case of the visceral leishmaniasis or the kala azar, the vector, this reservoir is mainly humans, right? Non-human reservoirs are, no extra human reservoirs are found in India. Now incubation period is 3 to 6 months, and kala azar and the visceral leishmaniasis, 90% cases are the fatal. And what happens ki bone marrow involvement होगा. Now, in case the bone marrow involvement is takes place, so anemia, leukopenia, thrombocytopenia, later causing to the pancytopenia is the important clinical presentation, with along with it the hypergamma globinemia, and it is also, it is non-specific but is important, presenting with the hepatosplenomegaly, right? And along with this, in India it is reported most commonly from where? From the Bihar and the sub-Himalayan regions. And the diagnosis mainly by the amastigate form, and the death is mainly occurs by the secondary bacterial infections. Now this is visceral leishmaniasis, also known as the dum-dum fever, derived from the name from the Calcutta, right? So dum-dum fever, and the presentation will be same, that is hepatosplenomegaly, and the cachexia, swollen lymph nodes, pancytopenia. Now coming to the post kala azar dermal leishmaniasis, it mainly occurs after the treatment, after the visceral leishmaniasis have been treated, right? From the 2 se 10 saal baad ke agar leishmania ke treatment ke baad post kala azar dermal leishmaniasis will appear, and in India it is reported less, and kya agar patient will present with the non ulcerative hyperpigmented macular lesions on the, and which later will become nodular. First they will be macular lesions, hyperpigmented, and later they will become nodular, as you can see. And the treatment is same, that is a long course of the antimonials. And coming to the virulence factor, important is to remember the glycoprotein, lipophosphoglycan, and the glycophosphatidyl inositol. In case you do not remember the virulence factor for the leishmaniasis, remember everything is by GG, like glycoprotein, lipophosphoglycan, and the glycophosphatidyl glycerin, phosphatidyl inositol. ठीक है. नाउ मूविंग नेक्स्ट टू लेबोरेटरी डायग्नोसिस. नाउ स्पेन इज द मोस्ट सेंसिटिव, फॉलोड बाय द बोन मैरो, एंड देन टू द लिवर एंड द लिम्फ नोड, एंड द लीस्ट सेंसिटिव इज द बफिकोट, राइट? टेकन फ्रॉम द बफिकोट, फ्रॉम द ब्लड सैंपल दैट वी टेक, एंड द माइक्रोस्कोपी, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन कि माइक्रोस्कोपी में वो क्या दिखेगा, अंडर द ब्लड स्टेन पेरिफेरल ब्लड्स में वी विल सी द एल्टी बॉडीज, दैट इज द एमेस्टिगेट फॉर्म, एंड कल्चर, द नेम ऑफ द मीडिया फॉर द कल्चर दैट वी यूज इज इंपॉर्टेंट. And that is the NNN media, that is the Neil Novi and the Nicole, and the Schneider's liquid media, Schneider's, right? And the important serological test that you perform, one is a non-specific, that is hypergamma globinemia, detected by the Napier's aldehyde and the Chopra's antimony test. Important, and the name of this test and the culture media is important to remember. And the specific, we actually see the ARK, K39 antigen of the Leishmania, and we check out the antibodies to the RK39 antigen by the immunochromatographic test. Okay, now moving next to the treatment. Leishmaniasis or the skin hypersensitive, delayed hyper skin sensitivity test after the intradermal injection of the Leishmanian antigen, and in case the positive test, an induration will appear after 48 to 72 hours, and it is positive in case with people with good immunity, those who have already successfully treated and presence with the lifelong immunity to the Leishmaniasis, right? And the negative in those who have the still have the active infection, the progressive infection, and case of the diffuse cutaneous Leishmaniasis, right? So this is how the delayed hypersensitivity, also known as the Montenegro reaction, and present with the erythema in duration in 48 to 72 hours, and we check the after the intradermal injection of the Leishmanian. Now coming to the treatment, the pentavalent antimony is the drug of the choice, and mainly the sodium stibogluconate. Right, and in India, in Bihar, almost 60% strains are resistant to the sodium stibogluconate. Therefore, we have to use the amphotericin B lipid formulation as the drug of choice for the Leishmaniasis. Right, and coming to the this prevention. Other than this, the miltefosine, paromomycin can also be used. But in case of Bihar, do remember that we use the amphotericin B and the sodium stibogluconate as in general, right? So moving next, sleeping prevention by controlling the insect is the most effective. Now coming to the cutaneous Leishmaniasis, the other clinical manifestation, and it may even appear after the latent infection, after years of having the latent Leishmaniasis, and the person will specifically present with the pizza base like ulcer. We can completely compare the two. This is pizza base, and this is a pizza base like ulcer. In case this pizza base like ulcers are present in more than on the whole body, so this will be the diffuse cutaneous Leishmaniasis. And the what are the causative agents for the cutaneous Leishmaniasis are the Leishmania tropica major, Mexicana, and the Ethiopia, right? And they do resolve spontaneously within 2 to 10 months. And the cutaneous Leishmanias is also known as the Oriental sore, Delhi boil, Baghdad boil, or the Lucknow boil. And the important is the pizza base like ulcer at the site of the bite by the sandfly. And the treatment is the same, that is the antimonials will be giving, this treatment will be same. Now another, that is the Leishmania Mexicana and the Leishmania Ethiopia sometimes do cause the diffuse cutaneous Leishmaniasis. And we have read that diffuse cutaneous Leishmaniasis, the skin test is what? Negative. Right, because it's an active stage, and where the active state of infection is present for the Leishmaniasis, the test, the skin test will be negative. Now coming next, this was about the cutaneous Leishmaniasis. One was the mucocutaneous Leishmaniasis, and the person, in case they resolve, the person will have the permanent defect of the face, the permanent scar of the face, and the 90% cases are reported from the Brazil and the Peru. Right, so these were some important few points. Now coming to the Trypanosoma brucei. Now one more important feature is that the Trypanosoma also do have the kinetoplast. Now what was the kinetoplast? Kinetoplast was the this network of the DNA in the mitochondria. So two important parasites having the kinetoplast. One is the Leishmania that just we have read, and another is the Trypanosoma. Right, so coming to the Trypanosoma is also known as the sleeping sickness, African sleeping sickness, and why it is sleeping known as the sleeping sickness, we'll read further, and we'll correlate with the this clinical manifestations, right? And the infective form, that is the Trypanosoma, so the infective form is the metacyclic form, metacyclic trypomastigate. Now in the Leishmania we saw that the ADMI A4A A mastigote form was the present in the, and the infective form was the promastigate form, and here the Trypanosoma, the trypomastigate form, metacyclic trypomastigate forms are the infective, and the definite host is man, right? and the mode of transmission is same by the byte of the CC fly, and the transforms to the long cylinder tripomastigate followed by the short stumpy forms infective form to the CC fly, right? So infective form is the metacyclic tripomastigates, and the mode of transmission is the bite of the CC fly. And the clinical features, they are further divided into the stage 1 and the stage 2, and the reservoirs are the mammals and the humans are the definitive host, and the infective form is the metacyclic tripomastigate form, and the mode is by the bite, right? So now the important clinical manifestation one is the stage 1 and the stage 2. Now stage 1, in the person will present with the febrile illness, this is how the CC fly. Now it is important to remember the pictures, because this is how directly asked. So now coming to the stage 1, the person will be present with the fever, lymphadenopathy, and the stage is known as the hemolymphatic stage. And one important sign is the Winterbottom sign. What is it? We'll see in the next slide. That is a Winterbottom sign. And the stage 2 that causes the African sleepiness, the progressive somnolence, insomnia, and the disturbance of the sleep rhythm is the main cause, that it is named as a sleeping sickness, because the person will present with the mania, delusion, and the disturbance of the sleep rhythm cycle of the person. Now this is what is the Winterbottom sign, right? What is Winterbottom sign? It is the lymph node enlargement at the back of the neck. That is one of the important cardinal sign, that is the lymph node enlargement, and it is one of the important cardinal sign of the African trypanosomiasis or African sleeping sickness. Now what is the diagnostic form? Now the tripomastigates form, the infective form was the metacyclic tripomastigates form. Diagnostic form is seen in the blood smear, that is the tripomastigates form, and on the CSF they show the Mott cell, that is the plasma cell containing IgM. So these are the two important things to remember. And apart from this, the antigen can be detected by the ELISA, or the antibody by the ELISA index fluorescence, this test. Now treatment is important for the stage 1, that was the hemolymphatic lymphatic stage, and the stage 2, that was the present of the delusion and the neurological conditions, right? So for the stage 1, the suramin and the pentamidine are the drugs. Now what is the difference between the East African, West African sleeping sickness? We'll see further. And for the stage 2, metoprolol or eflornithine is metoprolol. And the eflornithine is the drug for the stage 2. Now this is the Mott cell from the CSF we have taken. Now what was the Mott cell? Is the collection of the abnormal plasma cells containing the IgM, and this is the tripomastigate form. Now we'll see the difference between the tripomastigate form of the Trypanosoma cruzi and the cruzi. Now this is the thin kinetoplast. Basic difference is of the kinetoplast. Now coming to the Trypanosoma cruzi gambiensis and the Trypanosoma cruzi rhodiense. Now, Trypanosoma brucei gambens is also known as the West African sleeping sickness, and it is the East African, depending on the area where they are found, right? So, and the East African sleeping sickness or Trypanosoma brucei rodensis is fatal condition and have the high mortality. Right, so West African sleeping sickness caused by the same by the tsetse fly, that is the one is the Glossina palpis, and the Glossina morsitans, and the primary reservoir is not is human here, and they are animals. So commonly we talk about the Trypanosoma cruzi gambiens, and what was the treatment? Pentamidine for the gambiens and the Suramain for the East Africa. Right, now how do we remember the drugs for the West Africa and the East Africa? Can be remembered that the pants are weird are wore more in the West. So pentamidine. Just a second. That is, pants are worn more in the West. And how do we remember that Trypanosoma gambiens or rodensis can be remembered West? Pants are worn in the West. Gore, right? So from the G. So this is how we can remember gambiens, gore for gambiens, and the pens for pentamidine, that is the drug of the choice, and the West is the it's West African sleeping sickness, right? And the for the abnormal CSF, here we give the eflornithin, here melasorpol, right? So what are the important points here to remember? One is the Trypanosoma cruzi and the Trypanosoma brucei gambiens and the rodensis. So pants are worn in the West gore, that is the pants. Pentamidine is a drug of the choice. West African sleeping sickness is actually Trypanosoma brucei gambiens, right? So and the in case of the CSF, here eflornithin and here melasorpol is given as a drug of the choice. Now moving next to the Trypanosoma cruzi, that is the Chagas disease or the South American, right? So the brucei was the African, East African or the West African depending, and the Trypanosoma cruzi is the South American or also known as the Chagas disease. Now the life cycle, the life cycle is by the rubbing of the Radwig bugs or the kissing bug. Okay, so this is important to remember. There was by the bite of the tsetse fly, can be tsetse fly, and here by the kissing bug or the Radwig bug. Now infective form is the same, that is the metacyclic trypomastigotes. We are reading the Trypanosoma, so trypomastigotes form can be remembered are the infective forms, that are the metacyclic trypomastigotes form are the infective forms, right? And they invade the macrophage, now transforms into the amastigate forms, which multiply to form the pseudocyst. Now amastigate form again transforms to the trypomastigates form. Now the life cycle of the Trypanosoma is not important to remember, but some few points are important to remember is that one is the it's caused by the kissing bug or the Radwig bug, right? And the infective form is the metacyclic trypomastigates form, and inside the macrophage they also transfers to the amastigate form, right, which multiply to form the pseudocyst similar to that of the Leishmania. Now coming to the important, very very important clinical manifestation, one is the chagoma, that is the subcutaneous nodule, and another is the romana, right, that is the periorbital edema. Okay. So moving next, another there's lymphadenopathy and the hepatosplenomegaly and the chronic Chagas disease. They mainly present with the GIT manifestations and the cardiac manifestations. These two important we have to remember. That is the GIT, they will present with the mega esophagus and the mega colon. And the cardia, that is dilated cardiomyopathy, everything is dilated, can be remembered ki dilated cardiomyopathy, mega colon and the mega esophagus. In case of HIV, meningoencephalitis. Now what was the important points about the Trypanosoma cruzi, that it is known as the Chagas disease caused by the kissing bug or the Reddewick bug, and the infective form is the same, that is the metacyclic trypomastigate form. And Chagoma and the Ramona sign are important to remember. Now can be remembered that kissing on Ramona, Romana's eye, that is the Romana's sign, is periorbital edema, while the Chagoma is the subcutaneous nodule and caused by the kissing bug or the Reddewick bug. Now moving next, this is the Trypanosoma brucei and the Trypanosoma cruzi. Brucei was for the East Africa and the West Africa. East, we remember that pants are pants are worn in West Gore, that is the the drug that we use is the pentamidine here for the West African sleeping sickness, and is caused by the Trypanosoma brucei gambiens, Gore for G, right? So that is pan in West by Gore, right? That's Trypanosoma brucei gambiens in the West African sleepless sickness, or a drug of choice is the pentamidine, right? So Trypanosoma, what is the difference between the kinetoplast of the Trypanosoma brucei and the cruzi? And as we can see, this is the blood smear that we are under the microscopy, we are seeing the metacyclic trypomastigate form, and they are used for the diagnosis of the Trypanosoma brucei and the cruzi. And this is the Trypanosoma brucei with smaller kinetoplast, right, as you can see. And this is the Trypanosoma brucei with large posterior kinetoplast. Okay, and what was the kinetoplast? Kinetoplast is the is a network of the DNA in the mitochondria. Okay, now coming to the diagnosis and the treatment, that the culture for both the this Leishmania, what were the two important common points? Ek to dono ke paas kinetoplast hai, and culture media is same for both one, that is the NN media. Now diagnostic form we have seen, that is the trypanomastigate form in the blood smear is the diagnostic form, and the culture is seen on the NN media, right? And radioimmune precipitation is highly sensitive and specific. Other than this, PCR for detecting the kinetoplast, and the treatment is important, that is the benznidazole and nifurtimox, right? So this was about the diagnosis and the treatment. Now Chagas, what was the Chagas? It was the subcutaneous nodule, right? And mainly occurs often in the children. And one was the periorbital edema, that is the Romana sign. Okay, and the Romana sign is the when what happens, parasite is inoculated in the conjunctiva, causing the unilateral painless edema of the periocular tissue in the eye, also known as the Ramona sign or the periorbital edema. This is important to remember, that is the periorbital edema, that is can be remembered by the kissing on the Romana's eye, that is it is periorbital edema of the eye, and it is Ramona's sign by the kissing bug or the Reddewick bug. And another sign, that is the Chagas sign, is actually this chagoma sign is actually what subcutaneous nodule, right? And hepatosplenomegaly and lymphadenopathy is occasionally present. Now, revising the topic before ending the class, question answers we will not be doing today, and we will doing in the special class. Okay. So, Trypanosoma brucei. Now, Trypanosoma brucei is also known as the sleeping sickness, and why it is also called as a sleeping sickness, because the person's sleep-wake cycle and the sleep rhythm cycle is actually disturbed. Either he will present with the insomnia or insomnia or hypersomnolence and mania or the delusion. And the, in the stage one, actually present the winter bottom sign. And what was the winter bottom sign? It is actually the enlargement of the lymph node at the back of the neck. So it is the cardinal sign for the trypanosomiasis or the sleeping sickness. And the humans are the definitive host, and the infective host from the trypanosoma is the trypanomastigate form, metacyclic trypanomastigate form. And it's actually by the CC fly, by the bite of the CC fly. Now, two stages we have already seen, and this is the enlargement of the lymph nodes or the at the back of the neck in the cervical triangle, and it is the winter bottom sign and one of the important cardinal sign of the this trypanosoma. Now, diagnostic form is the seen in the blood smear, and along with this the Mott cells are seen. Now, what are Mott cells? These are the abnormal plasma cells containing the IgM antibody, right? Now, treatment is mainly the suramine, and for the West African is the pentamidine we have seen, and for the this is actually the Mott cell, and therefore the pentamidine for the trypanosoma brucei gambiens and the suramine for the rodents. Now, how to remember it's whether it's East Africa, West Africa? One more important thing is that the East Africa is actually have had the high mortality cases, and it is actually more fatal, and the pens are war in the West. This is how we can remember that the pens means pentamidine is a drug of choice, war in the West, that is the West African, and West Gore, that is the Gambians, right? And the Trypanosoma rodensis is East African sleeping sickness with suramine as a drug of the choice. And in case of the CSF, we either give the eflornithine in the West African and the amelasorpol for the East Africa, right? And moving next, Trypanosoma cruzi or the Chagas or the South African is mainly found in South America and is caused by the kissing bug or the radiovic bug, and the infective form is same, that is a metacyclic trypanomastigates form. Now, important two signs are the Chagoma and the Romana sign. Now, kissing on the Romana's eye, that is the Romana sign, is of periorbital edema. Kissing bug is the vector. Right, and Chagoma is the subcutaneous nodule, and trypanosoma mainly occurs in the children for less than 2 years. And the another chronic manifestations are the GIT and the cardiac is important to remember. Cardiac may be cardiomyopathy, dilated, and the megaesophagus and the megacolon, that is everything is enlarged. Now, Trypanosoma brucei and cruzi can be differentiated on the basis of the kinetoplast, right? So the kinetoplast is smaller in case of the brucei and the larger in case of the cruzi. So coming to the diagnosis and treatment, the culture media is same, that is the NN media, and the treatment is the benznidazole, right? So this is Chagas disease or the kissing bug disease or the Trypanosoma cruzi disease, that is C4C, that is Chagas or the cruzi, and is actually occurs in the children with less than 2 years. And in case unilateral periorbital edema, that is the Ramona sign, and the Chagoma, as you can see, is the subcutaneous lesion. So this was about brucei and the Trypanosoma and the Leishmania. Just revising the Leishmania 5 minutes before ending the class. Question will be doing the later. Okay, so how did we remember ki aadmi mein A se A, that is A mastigate form, mastigate form and fly may promastigate form, right? So infective was the promastigate form, and by the fly, by the bite of the female sand fly, and the amastigote form is present in the humans, right? And therefore, since it is present in the humans, it is the diagnostic form, right? And amastigate forms are taken by the immunity cells, by the macrophage, and they are present, they divide within the macrophage, also known as the LD body or Leishmania Donovani body. Now this is what the female sandfly or the free bottomus is, the vector and the mode of transmission, and the reservoirs are the humans and the mammals, right? So moving next, this is the life cycle, that is amastigate form is present in the when the actually when the sandfly sucks the blood, it releases the amastigate form, and the amastigate form taken by the macrophage, and within the macrophage they do not actually die, they actually multiply and causing later the LD bodies, and the amastigate forms then released this are released into the blood, and the amastigate forms are taken by the sandfly where they are converted in the promastigate form, and again the promastigate forms are released into the blood of the person, where in humans they are converted again into the amastigate form. Now Leishmania, mucosal, visceral and the cutaneous. Now cutaneous is less aggressive and resolves spontaneously within 2 to 10 months, and the mucosal is very rare, and it involves the mucocutaneous lesions, specifically nose and the oral cavity, and causing the permanent scar, permanent defect of the face, right? And the visceral, the 90% cases are fatal in case they are not treated. Now moving next, this is the kinetoplast. What was the kinetoplast? It is the collection of DNA in mitochondria. Not important in case you do not remember, just remember that the kinetoplast is present in both the Leishmania and the Trypanosoma, right? And amastigate form A4A is present in Aadmi, right? So moving next, Leishmania Donovani body, these are Leishmania Donovani body, that is the macrophage containing the amastigate form, they are further released into the blood, and this is how the cycles is take completed, taken by the sandfly. They are then converted into promastigate form, again comes to the human. Now coming to the visceral leishmaniasis, incubation period is about 3 to 6 months, and what is the most important point, as I told you, it is 90% is fatal in case not treated. Fatal, that means involves the bone marrow involvement, and since bone marrow involvement, therefore anemia, leukopenia and the thrombocytopenia, causing the pancytopenia, and increased immunoglobulin, that is hyper gamma globinemia, right, along with the hepatosplenomegaly. Okay. Now moving next, most common cause is the secondary bacterial infection, because the immunity of the person is highly decreased due to the pancytopenia. So the most common cause of the death is the secondary bacterial infection. Now this is the also known as a dum-dum fever, derived from the Calcutta. Okay. Now moving next is the post kalazadermal, that occurs after 2 to 10 years of successful treatment of the visceral leishmaniasis, and the person will present first with the non-ulcerative hypopigmented macular lesion, which later will become nodular, as you can see, right? The treatment is the same, and the virulence is by the GGG, that is the glycoprotein, lipophosphoglycan and the glycophosphatidyl inositol. Now important is the samples that we take. Spleen is the most sensitive, and the buffy cord, the blood sample, is the least sensitive. And microscopy, what do we see? We see the LD bodies or the amastigate form. And culture media, the name are important, that is the NNN media, Schneider's liquid media, and the gamma globin is non-specific, because in case of any other infection, multiple myeloma or the malignancy, also the gamma immunoglobulins do rise, right? And it is detected by the Napier's aldehyde test or the Chopra's antibody test. Another important antigen to remember is the RK39 antigen. That is important to remember, and we do check the antibodies against the RK39 antigen in the immunochromatographic test. Right, so RK30 antigen, do remember, along with the name of the media and the test that we do. And the another test is the skin test or the delayed hypersensitivity test, that in case it is positive or the negative after the intradermal injection of the Leishmaning antigen, and in duration will be present after 48 to 72 hours. In case the test is positive, it will indicate the resolved successful treatment either with good cell mediated immunity or the asymptomatic patients, and negative in case of the when cell mediated immunity is less and the patient with the active infection or the diffuse cutaneous leishmaniasis. Another is the PCR to detect the kinetoplast, and this is the same delayed hypersensitivity skin test with the induration after 48 to 72 hours erythema and the induration after the intradermal injection of the Leishmanian antigen. Treatment is important is the pentavalent antimonials, that is sodium stibogluconate and maglulin antimonate, but in the Bihar 60% are the resistant to the treatment, therefore we give the amphotericin B lipid formulation as the drug of the choice there. Right, so this was about the visceral. Coming to the cutaneous, now cutaneous is also known as the oriental sore or the Delhi boil or the Baghdad boil or the Lucknow boil, and as you can see the ulcer is similar to the pizza base like ulcer caused at the site at the site of bite. It will appear and it may appear after 2 to 10 months of the infection, and it resolves after 2 to 10 months spontaneously. Okay, and it is mainly caused by the trypanosoma, Leishmania tropica, Leishmania mexican, Leishmania major, and the Leishmania ethiopia. And Leishmania mexican and ethiopia also do cause the diffuse cutaneous leishmaniasis. Right. Now moving next, one was the mucocutaneous we have talked about. Coming to the trypanosoma, they also have the what? Kinetoplast. Now the coming to the trypanosoma brucei or the sleeping sickness. Why it is called sleeping sickness? Due to the sleep rhythm cycle is disturbed, causing mania and the delusion. The stage 2 disease, and stage 1 present with the Winterbottom sign, that is an enlargement of the lymph node at the back, and it is a cardinal sign, and it is caused by the CC fly. And caused vector is what? Infective form is what? Metacyclic trypanomastigate forms. Right, now stage 1, stage 2 we have talked. This is the Winterbottom sign, and the diagnostic we see in the blood smear, that is a trypanomastigate form, and the Mott cells are present. Now coming to the treatment, this is the Mott cell, that is a plasma cell containing the IgM. Right, now moving next, the brucei, that is the pans wore by West Gore. Right, G4 trypanosoma brucei gambiens, also known as a West African disease, and pentamidine is the drug of the choice, where here the suramine is the drug of the choice. And for the CSF, we give the eflornithine and milasarpol for the brucei rhodiensis. Right, and moving next, East African is more fatal and having high mortality. Trypanosoma cruzi, that is the kissing on Romana's eye. Can remember cruzi kissing on the Romana's eye? That is the trypanosoma cruzi. And C4 Chagas disease as well, and the kissing, that is the bug, why the kissing bug or the Reddewick bug, and the Ramona's eyes, the Ramona's sign is present on the eye, that is a periorbital edema, and the infective form is the same, that is the this is the kissing bug. Right, and by the rubbing of the kissing bug, not by the bite of the kissing bug. Now moving next to the another is the Chagoma, that is the subcutaneous nodules. And for the chronic GIT and the cardiac manifestation, that is the enlargement, that is the dilated cardiomyopathy, and the mega esophagus and the mega colon. Sab kuch mega ho gaya. Now this is the brucei and the cruzi with the kinetoplast. In the brucei comes the small kinetoplast and the large posterior kinetoplast in the Cruzy. Okay, so now moving next to the diagnosis, culture media is same, that is the NN media, and treatment is the benznidazole is the drug of the choice. Other than this, PCR can also be done to see the kinetoplast. Now, and C-shaped trypanomastigotes, as we see, the C-shaped trypanomastigate form is seen in the blood smears. Now, this is again the Chagas disease with the periorbital edema and the subcutaneous nodule, mainly in the children less than 2 years, and periorbital unilateral painless periorbital edema. So, this was about the today's class. Okay, so thank you for today's class, and please do use my code, that is Muskan, to get 10% of the discount. And in case you are working as a doctor, please be try to stay fair to workplace, because day by day the cases are increasing. So, and in case you are working studying from the home, so be safe at your home as well. Okay, so study well and have a good day. And thank you. In case you want to clear some topic and specifically read some topic, please do let me know. And thank you for today's session.